Hello friends, welcome to this video on polynomials. In this video, we will learn to find the factors of polynomials using the factor theorem and the method of splitting the middle term. So let's start with the first question. Check whether x minus 2 is a factor of the given polynomials. According to the factor theorem, if x minus 2 is a factor of these two polynomials, then p of 2 should be 0, where 2 is obtained by equating x minus 2 to 0. That is, if we write both these polynomials this way, we have to check whether p of 2 and q of 2 are 0 or not. So let's check. In both the polynomials, x has to be replaced by 2. And now, we get p of 2 is equal to 0 and q of 2 is equal to 12. Now, according to the factor theorem, we can say that x minus 2 is a factor of the first polynomial, but not a factor of the second polynomial. So, let's move on to the next question. Find the factors of the given polynomial. So friends, tell me, which method will you use here? Can we start with the method of splitting the middle term? Friends, this is a cubic polynomial and we use the method of splitting the middle term in the case of a quadratic polynomial. Therefore, we will solve this polynomial using the factorization method. The first step is to make the coefficient of x cubed 1 and find the factors of the constant term. Here, the coefficient of x cube is 1, which means we have to find the factors of minus 50. And this is quite easy. We just have to make a list of those numbers with which minus 50 is completely divisible and some of those possible values can be. And now, we come to the second step. One by one, we will substitute these numbers along with their signs in the polynomial and observe which number can make the value of the polynomial 0. So p of 1 becomes 0. P of minus 1 becomes minus 72. P of 2 becomes 84. P of minus 2 equals minus 72. P of 5, 600. P of minus 5, 0. P of 10, 2700. And P of minus 10 is equal to 0. Here, for the cubic power of x, we get 3 zeros. And since this is a cubic polynomial, there will not be any more zeros. And now, we can represent this polynomial in terms of its factors. P of x is equal to x minus 1, x plus 5, x plus 10. Friends, after finding the first factor, you can solve it without finding the other factors. Let's see how. When we got p of 1 as 0, we derived our first factor, x minus 1. So, now let's take x minus 1 common from this cubic polynomial. If this polynomial had minus x square after the first term, then after taking out the common x square, we will be able to write like this. But here, instead of minus x square, we have 14x square. So now what? We will subtract and add x square once from x cube. Now, we can take it common. If you take x square common from the first two terms, you will get x square of x minus 1. The remaining x square plus 14x square will become 15x square plus 35x minus 50. Now we can perform the same with 15x square. Here, if the first term was minus 15x, then by taking 15x common, we could write like this, 15x of x minus 1. So let's subtract and add 15x once. Now, again 15x and 35x will get added up to become 50x. Now, taking 50 common, we can write x minus 1. After this, by taking x minus 1 common from all the terms, we can express it like this, x minus 1, x square plus 15x plus 50. This is in the form of a quadratic polynomial. Can we now solve it using the method of splitting the middle term? Yes. Here, the coefficient of x square is 1 and the coefficient of the constant term is 50. And the two terms whose product is 50 and the sum is the coefficient of the middle term, that is 15, are 10 and 5. Pause the video and solve it yourself and see if the other two factors that you are getting are the same or not. Friends, that's all in this video. What did we learn in today's session? To find the factors of polynomials using factor theorem and the method of splitting the middle term. We will now meet in the next video. Thank you.